So hello friends, as we can see in this video that cutting tool and the workpiece. So we are attaching this tool, a single point cutting tool, with the help of this burr holder in a machine, and that single point cutting tool is cutting a cylindrical workpiece. So this is our cylindrical workpiece, and this is our end cutting edge angle, and this is our side cutting edge angle. Now we will move towards the geometry of single point cutting tool. So we know that this is end cutting edge, and this end cutting edge is making an angle, some angle with this perpendicular to this length. If we are drawing this length and we are drawing perpendicular to some perpendicular to this length, and if we calculate the angle between this end cutting and this perpendicular, which is perpendicular to length, then that is known as end cutting edge angle. And similarly, we are having side cutting edge angle, and this is our nose radius, and this is having, we are having a back rack angle and side rack angle, and similarly we are having a end flank angle and side flank angle, or we can also say we are having a side clearance angle and end clearance angle. Now this is our basic geometry of metal cutting, and we are having this rack face, and this is our shear, that's shearing of metal takes place. So always keep in mind that while calculating force, or while calculating using any relation in Merchant Circle diagram, we always use a back rack angle, not a side rack angle. So don't confuse with these two angles, and always put a back rack angle. This is just the basic process of metal cutting, and how the chip flows, as you can see, and how the tool moves forward. So we are having this machine surface, and this is an unmachined surface. So now here we have drawn a simple geometry of metal cutting. This is our tool, and we have drawn a perpendicular to this. So the angle included between these two can be written as alpha, and this is our phi, that is the angle with the shear plane and horizontal, and this is, we are having a cutting force. In the similar way, we are having this friction force, because if the chip flow in this direction, then we will have this friction force, because chip will stick to this tool, or they will apply some friction force over this surface. So as I am denoting this as this angle y alpha, and the chip flow in this direction. So alpha is, always keep in mind, this alpha is back rack angle, not a side rack angle. So while putting this alpha in formulas, always take back rack angle, not side rack angle, because the gate and ES used to give both angles. So you have to put a back rack angle if you are having back rack angle as well as side rack angle. Now we have drawn this geometry of simple metal cutting with single point cutting tool, and this is our F factor, friction force, this is FC, and this is our cutting velocity. So the cutting velocity and cutting force both have same direction. So we want to represent all these forces in terms of this circle. So we will take all these vectors inside this circle, because we can shift the vector. Now I will draw first this cutting force. So this is my cutting force. This is my cutting force, FC. Because I have shifted this FC from this place to this place, and I can shift a vector from one place to another place without changing its direction as well as magnitude. So I have not changed its direction as well as magnitude. So I have shifted it inside the circle. In the similar way, I can draw a force perpendicular to this cutting force, that is known as thrust force. So I can represent the thrust force by this vector FT. So I can write this as Ft, and this Ft and Fc have one, because this is right angle triangle, so I can draw this F resultant of these two, that is represented by R. So now I have drawn this R, so I can write this R in terms of Fc and Ft. If I know one of these angles, whether I can know the angle between this Fc and R or Ft and R, with the help of these two angles I can relate Fc, Ft and R. Now I will draw a plane perpendicular to this Fc. So, and we know that this plane I have shifted here, and this rack face I have shifted here. So I can write, if this is angle alpha, so in the similar way, this F, the plane perpendicular to horizontal, and F is having angle alpha. If this is angle alpha, in the similar way, I can write this angle, the angle opposite to this can also be. So this angle can be written as alpha, and this is our friction force. As we have shifted, I have shifted this friction force from this place to this place without changing its magnitude and direction. And we know that this is friction force, and we know that the force perpendicular to this friction force is known as normal force. So I can correlate these force by an angle beta. I am defining this friction angle as beta. So tan beta can be written as Fyn, friction force upon normal force. So as we know, this is a Merchant circle diagram. So we want to write a friction force in terms of cutting force as well as thrust force. So I can write F as a function of Fc and Ft. So for this, I will draw a perpendicular to this friction force. As you can see in the diagram, and I am writing this alpha. And by geometry, I can say that this, whatever we are having, this angle alpha with the rack surface, and the similar angle we will have with Fc and the perpendicular. So by geometry, we have drawn this alpha angle, and we can say this point as A, B and C. And if I will take this right angle triangle ABC, then I can write this F vector as a vector BC plus vector CD. And vector CB can be written as FC sine alpha if I will take the right angle triangle ABC. So I have shown this point as a D point. So I can write this vector F as a vector CD. And vector CD is a summation of vector CB and vector BD. And vector CB can be written as FC sine alpha, because this in triangle ABC, this Fc is hypotenuse, and we can take a component of Fc as Fc sin alpha. In the similar way, I can write vector BD, and vector BD is parallel to vector BM, vector EM. So vector BD is parallel to vector EM, and vector EM can be written as the cos component of vector Ft. So vector F can be written as vector CB plus vector BD, where vector CB is Fc sin alpha, vector BD is Ft cos alpha. So I can write vector CD equal to Fc sin alpha plus Ft cos alpha, and that is equal to vector F, that is nothing but friction force. So as I have already told you, I can write this vector n as a function of this cutting force as well as thrust force. So I can represent this vector n in terms of, so this is my vector ed, so I can write this vector n equal to vector ed. So I can write vector ED equal to vector BM. So, and vector ED can be written as equal to vector BM, and vector BM can be written as vector AB minus vector AM. So I can write this vector BM as a total vector AB minus vector AM. So this will represent vector BM. And I can write vector AB as a FC cos alpha, because I am having this right angle triangle ABC. So I can take a cos component of FC, because this FC is hypotenuse to this triangle. So I can take a cos component of this, that is FC cos alpha. So I can write vector FC cos alpha. Now I left with AM. So I can, this is my FT. So I can take, and this AME is a right angle triangle. So I can take FT sin alpha, because FT is hypotenuse to this angle. So I can write FT sin alpha. So vector N can be written as vector BM, and vector BM can be written as FC cos alpha plus, sorry, minus FT sin alpha. So I can write vector BM equal to FC cos alpha minus FT sin alpha. So this is the one of the standard relation that we used in metal cutting. And it is very important, because while appearing for GATE or ISRO, if we memorize this formula, we can directly correlate this normal force, and we doesn't have to utilize this Merchant circle, because it is time consuming to calculate all these angles and take components and all this process. So if it, and it is a simple formula, so you can memorize it. So here I have drawn a simple diagram, means whatever we have done earlier, so I have drawn in this diagram, and this is more clear as compared to earlier, because we are having lots of forces and components there. So here I can write F vector F equal to, this is my vector F. So vector F equal to FC sin alpha minus FT sin FC cos alpha. So friction force can be written as FC sin alpha plus FT cos alpha, and normal force can be written as FC cos alpha minus FT sin alpha. Now we want to draw a relationship between this cutting force, thrust force, and the shear force. So I will denote this extension point as a P. So I can write Fs equal to vector AP. Sorry, this Fs can be written as vector AG, and vector AG can be written as vector AP minus vector PG. So I can write vector AG equal to vector AP minus vector PG. So vector AP can be written as, if I will take a sine component, is the cos component of FC, because this FC is hypotenuse to this angle FPA. So I can take a cos component of this AF, and that is equal to AP. So I can write FC cos alpha is equal to vector AP. Now I know that this PG, this vector PG is nothing but equal to vector F. Now I will denote this point as a point M. I can denote this as a point M. So I can write vector PG equal to vector FM, because both are perpendicular, and this is our rectangle. So whatever vector, whatever magnitude of vector PG is there, the same magnitude we are having for FMD. Vector PG is equal to vector, so I can write vector PG equal to vector FM, and vector, as we know, this F, M and D is an, so I can write vector FS equal to vector AG is equal to vector FC cos phi minus FT sin phi. So this is also one of the most important formula in Merchant Circle diagram that you frequently used in different numerical problems in metal cutting. And this is, this phi is our shear angle. Now, as we have drawn a relationship between FS, FC and FT, in the similar way, we will draw a relationship between this normal shear force in terms of cutting force and thrust force. So, vector Fn can be written as, this is our vector Fn, and vector Fn can be written as vector Gp. Sorry, vector Gd. So we can write vector Fn equal to vector Gd because both are equal in magnitude and direction. We are representing here a vector Fn by vector Gd. So I can write vector Gd, it is equal to vector Dm plus vector Gm or Mg. Now, I can write vector dm equal to ft cos phi because this fmd is a right angle triangle. So, I can take cos component of ft, that is nothing but equal to dm. And in the similar way, I can take this triangle fpa and I will take the sine component of this AF, that is nothing but equal to FC sin phi, and as we know, these two are PF and GM are parallel lines and both are having an equal magnitude, so I can replace vector GM by vector PM and vector GM by vector PF, and vector PF is equal to FC sin phi. So I can write vector Fn equal to vector Gd and vector Gd equal to Fc cos phi, sorry, Fc sin phi plus Ft cos phi. So this is also one of the important formulas in metal cutting. So now I can relate the different properties of material with shear force. So as we know, the whole metal cutting process is a shear process. Shear cutting or shear strength process. So I can write Fs equal to tau s into Bt upon sin phi. So this Fs can be written as this tau into Bt upon sin phi. And with the help of Fs, we can calculate different forces of Merchant Circle diagram. Like we can find out the resultant if we know all the angles. So, this is all related to